Hello and welcome to Advanced Rocketry. In this tutorial series, I will go through basically everything in the mod, or at least I'll try to remember. Perhaps I'll miss some things. If I do, then of course, just tell me so. We'll go through everything from ores, how to build these multi-block structures. We will go to the moon. We have rockets over there waiting for us. We will go through lots of machines and, yeah, as I said, hopefully everything that you need to know about this mod. But everything starts with ores. The mod adds a few ores, copper, tin, aluminium. They may be added by other mods as well. I'm doing this in a very slimmed down pack. You can find more information about that in the video description. And also in a mod pack, recipes might be a bit different, but I'm trying to do this as vanilla as I can. And I'll show the recipes very briefly. I know you have JEI or NEI or whatever, but I still will think it's important to show them, because it gives you an idea of when you can craft them in a mod and what prerequisites there are. Okay, so let's start here. We have Dilithium, we have Rutile and Iridium also added, not standard ores perhaps, but and I think all of these will be on the earth and end up in the sky, but at least Dilithium is much more common if you go to the moon, for example. I'm not sure if you can find it on Earth at all, but go to the moon and you will find lots more anyway. So, and the first machine we'll build is the small plate presser. So this is a way to get early ore doubling. Just dump it. You mount it like this. You need to have obsidian down below, and after that just place your ores here and hit the button, and this will give you some aluminium dust, and as you can see, it's, you get double the amount. So then you can smelt it in the furnace, copper dust, tin dust, aluminium, iridium, but the rutile and dilithium. Well, let me see here. If we take the dilithium, sure thing, I can crush it. Rutile can't be crushed, so we'll get back to that a bit later. The dilithium dust as well, but you can't, we'll save those for later, but for now you have all the aluminium and copper and tin and whatever. After you have that, then you can actually make some blocks. They look like you expect, blocks of aluminium. They are crafted like normal blocks. Nothing strange with that. The good thing now is that we can use our plate presser, the small plate presser to be more specific. You just place a block of steel down beneath. Oops. That was weird. Let me clear out here. So block of aluminium. This will give you aluminium plates. Steel. And so on. Oops, they end up back here. Alright. So now we have not only blocks, we have plates as well. You got four from one block, so not really half the amount of ingots, but you can improve this later on in the mod when we get to the machinery. So, but this will work for now. We have gold, we have titanium. Now titanium is, well, we'll come to that. Alright, very, very shortly, just over here. Now, we have all the all the base materials. Now we can start crafting things, optical sensors. And with that, we can now make the Holo-Projector. And this is your building guide. It's very useful. You right-click in the air without, if you look at something, of course, it will go into that. But if you just right-click in the air, then you get into the Holo-Projector's GUI. And there are lots of machines here. And I think the first one we'll take a look at is the electric arc furnace, because it's probably the first one you will build unless you're in a mod pack and you have other ways to get all the steel and titanium. But we'll begin with that. And it's clicked, and if you hover over it, it will show you all the resources you need. So we need an electric arc furnace, we need power input plugs, three of them. We need air. There's air in the middle. We need gold coils or copper coils or a few different types of coils, or you pick one. But just give me a few seconds and I'll show you. And we need hatches and heatproof bricks. So let's see how we can get all that. Heatproof bricks. Just bricks and magma cream, easy to get. And then the electric arc furnace, nether bricks. We need some interface circuits, not too hard actually. These are the three basic, not basic circuits, they are circuit boards. There are other types of circuits that are called basic circuit. So these three, gold dust, plates, diamond, or then copper for this one and lapis for this one. There are other ways to make this, easier ways. You can also build them in the precision assembler, but we'll get to that in probably then in the next video. But you can make them for your first furnace, and you can make them like this. And we need a user interface. Dye, dust, paints, nothing weird with that either. And then the coils that I mentioned. So, standard recipe, this is the recipe for all of them. You can check the gold, titanium, aluminium, iridium, so same recipe. And copper is the basic one. It's the 100% efficiency. Then if you use gold or aluminium, titanium or iridium, you will boost the performance of the structure that you're building. So basically that means that we can this furnace will be faster if we use gold coils instead of copper coils. Okay? And then we have the power input plug, small battery, machine structures. Nothing strange with these either. Rods, plates, yeah. Rods, easy to make. Battery, also easy to make. Just use your tin plates and iron rods. Then you get your small battery. And you can also upgrade this to be, let me see, a double battery with this recipe. And before we start building, I should mention that we have something called an energy pipe, copper rod, clay. This is your way to transfer power in this mod. You can use other mods as well. For this one, in this video, I think I'm only using this energy pipes, but you can use other as well. And then we need a few of these final blocks. We need input hatch, it's just a structure and a chest, and then the output hatch, which is a variant of the input. And before we get started, let me just mention that you can actually make some create energy in the mod as well. Just craft yourself a coil generator. Right, give me that. And we get 40 RF per tick, so you can use this unless you have other mods. And I can see the moon is coming up here. Alright, so let's take a look at the electric arc furnace. This is a quite large structure. It has some interfaces, output hatch. It doesn't have to be there. I'll show you soon. Input hatch. And on the top we have the input plugs. But it's quite hard to build this just from memory. And that's why I selected the the electric arc furnace here in the Holo-Projector. Because I'll rebuild it for you back here. And if I just right click on the ground where I want it, then you can see I get these ghost blocks. So and if I shift and scroll, I will step through the different layers of the structure, and finally this is the full size of it. And as you can see, it will also tell me what brick I should build. So let me do this. I can middle click, I'm in creative mode, so I can do like this. And then if we go up a step, here we can see that some of these blocks are changing. That's because all of these blocks can be either one. You can have an input, you can have output, or just a brick. So I'll place bricks all around. And then I'll place the input and output over here. So now this is the output, this is the input. And here I'll place the electric arc furnace. It's the one that we crafted here. So we only need one of those, and the rest is base material. And now the final steps. So here's the coils. Titanium, aluminium, iridium. I'm not sure what I will use. Let's go for titanium. That's good. And then we go up one step further and place the final ones. Heatproof. So here we can use power plugs, or we shall use power plugs. So here I've hooked everything up to this thermal expansion energy cell. But for this build, I'll just use the creative power plug. And now I think everything is done. Just right click here on the furnace. Nothing happened. So that should mean that it has formed. So now we have the electric arc furnace. This is the on-off switch. This means that we have power. This is the input where we place our, let's see, sand, for example. If you just turn it on here. That was quick, I think. This is speed 2.37. If you take a look over here. Not there. And place sand in here. And let's see how we should get it here, I think. Yeah, speed is 1. So we are pretty much faster here. 2.37. Here's the progress bar. So this sand will turn into silicon. Well, let me see if I can find it here. Here. Sand, silicon ingot. And 600 seconds is probably at one times the speed. And now if I sped things up, it will take, well, half as long or something. And there are a few things you can make in here. If you combine iron and charcoal, you will get steel. If you go with aluminium and titanium, you will get titanium titanium aluminide. And to get titanium, you throw your rutile ore in here, and that's where the titanium comes from. And then you can refine the titanium into alloys with aluminium or using iridium. That's the one I wanted. So the iridium is from the normal iridium ore that you can find, that we can run, as you remember from the beginning. So I think it was here. Yep, iridium dust, iridium ingots. So that's how the arc furnace works. Here's the output. You can have output here, here, here. You can have inputs over here. You can mix those like you want, but some other recipes with the Holo-Projector are pretty much fixed, so you can't change anything. But typically these hatches are the ones that you can move around in some structures. So is this done yet? It's almost done. And with that, I think we have covered pretty much what I wanted to cover for this first episode. Basics, how to get started, how to build the multistructures, and then in the next episode we'll get back with other types of machinery and what they are good for. Ah, and there it's done. Yeah, like me. Alright, thanks for watching, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Take care, and bye-bye.